guys, for today's Anatmos video, I thought I would do a Q&A, so I've already asked you guys for questions both on my Instagram as well as my community page, so I thought it would be a good time for some of you guys to get to know me a little bit better, because I have a lot of new subscribers, which is a little mind-blowing, not gonna lie, and a little bit overwhelming, but I do feel like I owe it to you guys to just tell you a little bit more about myself maybe, and you guys have some really good questions, so I'm excited to answer a lot of these. This isn't going to be like a very controversial Q&A with like very spicy questions. At least I don't think so. I haven't looked through like all of these in a while, so I don't know exactly which ones I'm going to pick out, and I also won't have time to answer all of these because I probably got like 100 questions total, which is a lot, and it could make for like a 3-hour long video, and I just don't want to edit that. And you guys probably don't want to watch a 3-hour video anyway, so I think we should just get into the questions. So I'm going to start off with the ones that I have on my Instagram first, but I also want to say that if you want to see like a real get to know me video, I will link that up in the corner. I made it last year and I shared a lot of things that I don't really ever talk about on my channel. So if you want to know like the whole backstory of my life that I might not be answering very in depth in this video, you can go check out that video. It's a little bit sappy and I definitely cried a little bit, but if you do want to see it, it'll be linked up there. So let's start off with the first one here. It says, when did your makeup obsession start and how? I've always worn makeup ever since I was, I want to say like 14. I used to start with like eyeliner and stuff, and I think I've worn like base makeup, like foundation, ever since I was probably 17, like pretty much every day since I was 17, I've worn like the basics, but I don't think I got into wearing like fun makeup. I mean, I dabble, like when I used to do eyeshadow from time to time, it would always be colorful shadows because I've always enjoyed color. I've always been kind of an artistic person. I really used to like painting and drawing and stuff like that, and I never saw makeup as a way to just make me look better. Like, I always saw it in an experimental kind of way. So I want to say that I started really playing with makeup probably around 3 years ago now, maybe like 2.5 is when I started getting really into watching YouTube videos. So that's definitely when I got the most inspired to really play with makeup myself. And once I discovered just how much fun it is to do makeup and how good it makes me feel, I kind of was hooked after that. And so I would binge watch YouTube for about a year straight. And then I was like, you know what? I've had enough. I need to start my own channel because this looks like way too much fun. And I wanted to become part of the community so bad because I respected so many people that made videos. And I really wanted to like get to know everybody and just like be part of this happy community, which is the small beauty community. I feel like there's not a lot of drama in the smaller beauty community. And I was just sick of like all the, you know, all the bigger people just all looking the same. And I felt like YouTube needed more people who weren't afraid to just like play with makeup. So I kind of felt like there was room for me, and that's sort of how I like ended up on the platform, if you will. That was a very long answer for saying how long I've been obsessed with makeup. Next question. Do you miss anything about your poker days? Now, if you're new to my channel, you might not know this, but I used to be a professional poker player. I played poker professionally for just over 10 years. I used to travel quite a bit to play in poker tournaments, and I have a long history of being a winning poker player, and it was something that was so, so, so much fun to me while I was doing it, and it was a huge passion of mine. It was something that I never thought I would quit doing, but kind of along the way, I lost my passion for the game, and at the same time, the game started becoming a lot tougher because when I first got into the game, not that many people really knew how to play, and there just wasn't that much information out there. But as the game evolved and more information became available, there would be like training sites popping up and you can hire coaches and stuff. And like the level of play that was where I used to play at, meaning like the amount of money that I was playing at, I used to easily be able to beat. But the more the game kind of evolved, the better people got and the harder it would be to like make money at the stakes that I was playing at. So that kind of, along with me just not really having that much fun playing anymore, I decided that it was time for me to stop and like find something else to do. So I don't really think that I miss it that much. I mean, it's not really something that I ever think about on a daily basis anymore, but I do enjoy playing just for fun. Like, we are going home to Norway for Christmas. When you're seeing this, I might even be there. I'm not sure when this is going up, but we do have like a home game plan and just like family getting together and playing just for fun. But I never have the urge to like go to the casino and play poker anymore. Like, it's kind of like, it's in my past, you know? It's one of those things that I don't want to be known as the poker player anymore. I don't know, I want to kind of get away from that. So I've tried my best to just focus my attention on other things because this is what I enjoy now, this is what I want my life to be now, and so I don't want my past to be, you know, stuck to me forever. So even though I did really enjoy the time that I did play poker, I don't really ever think about it that much anymore. Will you do a beauty room tour? If not, on YouTube, on Insta? I don't think I will. I mean, this right here is my beauty room and it's not like an aesthetically pleasing room. Like, I'm not one of those people who has like white furniture that all like matches each other, and I've never been into interior design. I'm very much a functional human being. Like, as long as I have some kind of storage to put my stuff in, like, the stuff goes in the drawer and it doesn't have to be organized. Like, I basically have like a drawer of highlighters, a drawer of this, a drawer of that, and they're not stacked very nicely. I don't have, like, you know, those things that people put up, like organizers. Like, I don't have those little like organizing things that you like stack together and stuff. Like, I don't care. So I have no interest in like showing my beauty room because it's never going to be like a very nice looking beauty room, because that's not who I am. Like, I am a very messy person in general, so I kind of enjoy it being a little bit messy around me, and I don't need everything to be perfect because it makes me feel really uncomfortable when I'm at a place where everything is just like white and clean and smells fresh, and just, I feel like I wouldn't be able to touch anything, and like, that's not who I am. So I just feel like I don't want to be judged for my mess, if that makes sense. So I have no desire to really clean up and show people a side of me that's not what I'm really like, and I feel like I would have to do that in order to really show like my beauty room, or to be able to call my room like a beauty room tour. I don't know if I'm making any sense, but just that whole concept makes me really uncomfortable just because of how much an imperfectionist I really am. So I don't think that's ever going to happen, but I mean, I will easily do a collection video if that's what you want to see, but I'm never going to do like a,
oh, here's my beauty room, isn't it beautiful?
Like, that's just not going to happen. How old are you? I'm 31, which a lot of people seem to not believe that because they say I look very young, which I've always looked really young. I have very good genes. I'm very thankful for that. And so right now I feel very happy with the fact that I can say that I'm 31, and it's not something that bothers me anymore when people think that I'm like 20. You know, when you're like 21 and people think you're 15, that's when it's a problem. But when I'm 31 and people think I'm 25 or 22, like, I'm fine with that. Like, that's awesome now. So I feel like it's one of those things, like, the older you get, the better it is to look young, but when you're young you just want to look old. But I'm now at the stage where I'm like very proud of being able to say that I'm 31, so now you know I'm pretty old. I feel like I'm a lot older than a lot of other beauty YouTubers, but then again, I don't really see myself as a beauty guru. Like, that name is just like, it's a little bit icky to me. Like, I don't know, am I really a beauty guru? I don't know. I feel like there's no word that can really explain what I do here without me kind of cringing a little bit. Like, even like influencer makes me feel a little bit like yucky. So I don't know, I'm just like a, what would I even call myself, a makeup enthusiast on YouTube, I guess you could say. What inspired you to become a makeup artist? Now, I want to just like mention, every time I hear the term makeup artist, I feel like that's a term that nobody on YouTube should use about themselves, because I'm not a makeup artist. I'm a makeup enthusiast. I'm someone who really enjoys makeup. I have no experience with makeup other than doing makeup on myself. I don't have a license. I don't have any credentials that can, you know, make myself call myself a makeup artist. Like, I feel like a makeup artist should be saved for someone who is actually qualified to be called a makeup artist, and that is not me. So yeah. Where do you feel the best brushes come from? That's a very weird question to get in the Q&A, but I don't know, I feel like you can find really good brushes everywhere. Don't get me wrong, I'm going to mention my refer brushes, but like, those are amazing, and I know that some people aren't interested in using like goat hair brushes, and I totally understand that, but like, quality wise I guess like the best handmade natural bristled brushes would come from Japan. But other than that, I mean, you can find good brushes everywhere. I feel like BH Cosmetics has really good brushes, Sigma has really good brushes. I don't know where those are made, but I would assume that some of them are probably made in China. I don't really know. I mean, honestly, I think that you can make any brush work, and I think that the most important thing about a brush is more the size and the shape of the brush rather than the quality of the actual bristles and the brush itself. Like, of course, it's going to fall apart quicker than something that's made out of like better materials and stuff, but I feel like if you're just starting off, you should definitely try to figure out like what kind of shapes and size brushes that you like the most before like investing in really good brushes. So I don't know really how else I would explain or answer that question, because I feel like good brushes could come from anywhere. What would be your last meal? Oh my goodness, that is such a hard one. Like, I don't even know if I have like any specific favorites. I mean, there is this one thing in Australia. I'm actually going to Australia in January and I'm so excited because I'll get to eat these, but there's a market in Australia where they have like freshly deep fried churros. Churros is one of my favorite foods, but it needs to be like the perfect churros. If you can get a perfect churro with like dipping sauces, it's like the best thing in the world. And a lot of people think that they have had good churros, and then, you know, I try the churros that they like and I'm like, you know what, you've never had a good churro, because the churros in Australia are just amazing. So those would definitely have been part of like my last meal, but other than that, I don't really know what I would choose, honestly. I would probably just want to have like a bunch of like sweet stuff laid out all in front of me, and then I would just like eat all of the sweets until I got sick and then I'd die happy, you know? Like, I don't need like a pizza or like any kind of savory food. Like, if it was my last meal, I would want to feel like absolute shit after I'm done eating it. So I would be super happy with just eating sweets, because that is what I crave most of the time. That is the kind of food that makes me happy. Like, I can take it or leave it, whatever savory food that you have. I only eat savory food because it's like good for me and I should, you know? So yeah, it would definitely be mostly sweets, like a full table of like desserts and ice creams and churros and cake, and oh, that would just make me so happy. You had an exciting life, poker, traveling, YouTube. If you had to settle for a normal job, what would it be? This is extremely hard for me to answer because I have never had a real job, which is crazy to say, and it's something that I kind of steer away from like talking about a lot on my channel, because I know I've had like an extremely privileged life, and I know that my life is very unrelatable to a lot of people, and it makes me not want to talk about it because I don't want to come off as if I'm like bragging because I've had a very lucky life, if you know what I mean. And I still feel like I have an extremely lucky life and I'm very thankful for that, but I really don't want to like rub that into anyone's faces and make people feel like they're worse than me because I've never had a job or whatever. Like, I have so much respect for the people who go to work every day, and I know that I'm in the minority and I know how lucky I am. But with all that being said, if I had to have like a real 9-to-5 job or whatever, honestly, I don't really know what that would be. Like, I have never envisioned myself as someone working for someone else. Like, I've always kind of wanted to do my own thing. So it would definitely be some kind of a self-independent work from home kind of job, but I honestly don't know what that would be, because I dropped out of high school to play poker, so I don't have an education at all. Now, I did grow up in Norway and the school systems are quite different in Norway, so it's not like I would have gotten like a GHD or whatever if I did finish high school, so it doesn't really work like that back home. So me saying I dropped out of high school means I dropped out of high school in Norway, not like dropped out of high school in the States. I just want to kind of clarify that. So since I don't have an education, I don't have a degree, I never went to school for something that I wanted to do because I never knew what I wanted to do before I found poker. And since I found poker so early, I was 15 when I started, I never really had time to like figure out what kind of job I wanted to do. I did kind of start studying to become an interior designer, which is funny thinking back at, but I wanted to do something like artistic that would make me be able to be creative and stuff, but it wasn't something that I enjoyed doing, and I only did that for like a year. So honestly, I don't know what I would do if I had a job. I really have no clue. I feel like I would just end up working in retail because I don't have any experience in anything else, and there's nothing really that I'm so passionate about that I would want to work with. But now maybe it would be something like social media based, like maybe that could be kind of fun. I honestly just don't really know because I've never had to consider it, which is, again, I know I'm so lucky. Like, I don't want people judging me because I've never had a job, so like it's hard for me to really talk about this, and like, I don't know, it just makes me really uncomfortable. What do you like the most about living in Las Vegas? So I do live in Vegas, if you didn't already know. I did move to Vegas because I was playing poker for a living, and I just ended up here because I met my husband here in Vegas about, when did I meet him? I wanna say it's been like 8 years now since I met him. We've been married for about 5. We did get married at a chapel here in Vegas, which was pretty cool, so we never had like a big wedding or anything. But wait, what was the question again? What do I like the most about living in Vegas? Definitely the weather. It's always sunny here. I absolutely love it. I hate the winter and we never get any snow. It does get cold in Vegas though. Like right now during the day, it's around like 50 degrees or so, and then it'll drop down to like 40, 35 at night. It gets sometimes even colder than that. So people who think that the desert is like a very hot place, they're wrong, because it definitely does get really cold in the winter and at night, but the summers here absolutely suck. But I would rather have like a way too hot summer than a way too cold winter with a lot of snow and stuff. And since we also never get rain and stuff here, like even when it's cold, it's not that bad because it's always sunny. And the same can be said for like the summer. Like even though it's hot, like there's no humidity, so it's not that bad. So I think the weather is definitely the part that I like the most about living in Vegas. But also it's very cheap to live here. Like the cost of living, properties are really cheap and everything. I don't know. I like it here a lot. There's not really anything that I would say I don't like about living here. What is your everyday makeup look? Well, you're looking at it right now, because I film like 90% of the time I do my makeup, probably like 95% of the time. So what you see is what you get, basically. And if I'm not filming, I'm probably not even doing eyeshadow. I might just do my base and some mascara if I'm having like a very light day, or I might not do makeup at all. It really depends. But if I'm going to put on eyeshadow, like it's gonna be something fun and crazy and inspiring and something that I had fun creating. So this could be like an everyday look for me. I mean, like I said, I don't have a job which requires me to wear certain things or have a dress code or anything like that. So I just wear whatever makes me happy, and that's fun makeup like this. What are your plans for the future of your channel? How do you want to grow? Do you want to be one of the big beauty gurus? I definitely don't want to be one of like the big beauty gurus. Holy crap, that sounds so scary. Like, can you imagine that many people with eyes on you? Now, I definitely do have goals for my channel. I mean, my goal with my channel would be to just be able to contribute to the household and like make some money and be able to make a living out of this. Now, I'm very grateful to have a husband that's extremely supportive, and you know, we're doing pretty good financially, not just from my poker days, but like he's doing really good, and like we're in a good spot financially. So even though I'm not making a lot of money right now, my goal is definitely to be to just be able to contribute a little bit more and like, you know, bring in some more money so we have more to spend or more to save or whatever it is that we want to do with the money. Like I just want to be able to feel like I'm doing my part a little bit more, and like in case something were to happen in the future, like I would like to be able to know that I can make a living from doing this, even though right now like that is not the case at all. But I do put in a lot of money and effort into my channel as an investment into my channel, not just with like the equipment that I've bought, but also I kind of see my makeup purchases as an investment into my channel. So even though I don't necessarily get the money back from the products that I do buy yet, I still see it as a way to help me grow my channel. So I don't know, I mean, I do have goals for my channel, like I said, but I don't want to ever have like a million subscribers. Like that sounds so scary. Like, oh my god, like I got out of poker to kind of get away from the attention, because I used to be pretty successful and a lot of people knew who I was in the poker industry, and that was not something that I signed up for at all when I started playing poker. It just sort of happened because I was a girl and I happened to win some tournaments and like people thought that was really cool. But yeah, I don't want to get in a position again where I have like a ton of eyes on me, which sounds crazy to say because I'm on YouTube and I'm doing this, but this to me doesn't feel the same as having like real people come up to you on the street and be like,
"Hi, are you Annette? Are you the poker player?"
Like that to me was weird, but I guess the same thing could happen if I got a lot of subscribers. I don't know. I don't want to think about that. I just want to sit in my room and put on makeup and be happy and make some money doing it. Like, is that too much to ask for? Like, that is what I would like to do. I don't know. I don't know what I'm trying to say here. Like, I guess you can't have it all, but I don't want to be famous. Like, I just want to make a little bit of money. What is your favorite chocolate? Oh my goodness, I have been on such a kick lately, because every December, this one brand called Private Selections comes out with these kind of jars of chocolate that are caramel, sea salt, dark chocolate, and holy crap, they are good. If I can find a picture, I'll pop it up on the screen, but my husband and I have gone through so many of those, and Like, right now, that is my favorite chocolate by far. I mean, I really like any kind of chocolate. I'm not the biggest fan of chocolate with nuts in it or chocolate with fruit in it, but I love, like, caramel and chocolate, caramel, sea salt, chocolate, sea salt, nougat, to, like, oh my god, just, like, any kind of other chocolate that doesn't have nuts in it. I love, like, okay, Reese's are awesome, but, like, it has to be, like, nut butter and not, like, crunchy nuts. Like, I don't like chocolate with nut pieces in it. I think I'm alone in that, but that's never been, like, a thing for me. But I would say, like, somewhere between, like, milk and dark chocolate would be my favorite. I don't love milk chocolate, and I also don't love super dark chocolate, but somewhere in, like, the 60% chocolate range. Wow, this is a very drawn-out answer for what kind of chocolate I like. Honestly, I just like chocolate, okay? Like, I don't want to have to juice. Okay, so we're gonna move over to the community tab now. I feel like that was a lot of questions from Instagram. Maybe I shouldn't have answered that many because now I'm gonna be here forever. So this person says, I actually got a lot of questions about this, but this person says, your hair always looks so vibrant and healthy. Would love to know about your process when changing colors. Well, I actually go to a salon to get my hair done because I don't know how to do this myself. I'm not a hairdresser. I don't want to ruin my hair. So I do go to a salon to get it done, but to maintain my color, I'm very particular with like the products I use. I make sure that I use sulfate-free shampoo and conditioner because those can really strip the color out of your hair. And I also try to make sure I wash my hair in very cold water, which sucks in the winter, and I haven't done a very good job at doing that. But when I do notice that my hair is looking a little bit faded, I will mix some hair dye in with my conditioner and kind of leave that in while I'm like doing other things in the shower for about 10 minutes, and then I'll rinse it out. And usually that will help me like maintain the color if I feel like it's getting a little bit too faded. Right now, I don't really care if it fades a little bit because I am going to get my hair done again in January, probably before our trip to Australia, which I'm really excited about. So I'm probably going to start kind of trying to get the color out of my hair a little bit, but I still want my hair to look nice for Christmas. So it's like it's tough because I only wash my hair about once a week. That's another thing that's very important. I mean, the less you wash your hair, the better it's going to stick in your hair because you're not like putting water on it all the time. And that's what makes, you know, the color get out of your hair, because this is a semi-permanent hair dye. So it's going to just come out of your hair because it's sitting on top of your hair. It's not like a permanent hair color that really gets into your cuticles and like stays there. Like, this will strip out very easily. So I'm not like too worried about it, but yeah, that's basically how I maintain my color. And I've been having so much fun having colored hair, and I really love this green. I can't help it. Like, green was the first crazy hair color that I ever did, and I knew I loved it back then, but I didn't know how much I loved it until I've gone through like the other colors that I've had. And now that I'm back to green, I'm like, oh, I feel like myself with green hair. So I don't know how much longer I'm going to be keeping this. I am going to change it in January, and then after that we'll see what happens. Maybe I'll go back to green, maybe I'll do something else, I don't really know. But yeah, I think I'm gonna go turquoise next, and I'm very excited about it because that is a color that I've never had before. How would you suggest someone transition into wearing the bold colors like you do? I typically wear neutrals because honestly they're hard to mess up, but even if I mastered an eyeshadow look with bold colors, I'd be afraid it'd be such a shock to people I work with and my friends and family that I'd probably talk myself out of wearing it. Any suggestions on acclimating yourself into bold colors? I would say just kind of start slow. Like, you don't have to do what I'm doing on my eyes right now in order to, you know, work with colors. I would say that next time you're doing your makeup, like, do your browns or whatever it is that you want to do. Maybe build up like a brown crease, and then you can start by maybe adding in like one color to your look every single day. Maybe it could be on your lower lash line, maybe it could be as a shimmer on your lid, but just start by working in one colorful eyeshadow in all of the looks that you end up doing, and that will be like a good start. You could even start just by wearing like a colorful eyeliner in your waterline or something like that. It doesn't have to be like all out blue smoky eye the first time you do, like, you know, some kind of a crazy eye look. Like, you could just start small. I do think I'm going to do a video in the new year at some point, kind of like a how to get into colorful makeup for beginners type of 10 look video. I think I want to do that. I don't know when it's going to be coming. Those videos take forever to make, and since we are going on vacation, I'll probably not be home until like February. So probably be coming in like February, March, April at some point. I know it's a long ways from now, but if you want to start getting into colorful makeup, just start small, you know? Even just like transitioning from using a brown in your crease to maybe something like mauves or something that still has a little bit of like neutrally tones to it, but not like a bright fuchsia pink, you know? Maybe just like some muted colors that are still colorful without being browns would be a good place to start. Again, like shimmery shadows on your lids with a brown crease would be a good place to start. something colorful on your lower lash line maybe, or maybe just like a pop in the inner corner of like a light green or something. Like there are so many things that you can do to really get into color without it being like super colorful, you know what I mean? If you could only use one brand of eyeshadow, which one would it be? I'm not going to answer that because that is not fair, I don't like it. What is your favorite, least favorite genre of music? What type of TV shows, movies do you enjoy, and also what type do you not enjoy, and why for both? That's a very long question. Honestly, I'm going to sound like such an outsider right now, but I never watch TV, like, ever. Main reason for that is because I can't sit on the couch because the couch really hurts my back. I do have chronic back pain, and so the only chair that's really comfortable for me to sit on is like a desk chair, and I have two of the same exact chair in my house, and it's what I sit on at all times because it's the only things that don't hurt my back when I sit for long periods. So the fact that I can't really sit or lay on the couch or like in any kind of soft chair makes me not want to watch TV because it's the only place that the TV is. So I've stopped watching TV. Like I basically watch everything on my laptop, and that's mainly YouTube or like Netflix or YouTube, or did I say YouTube twice? Or iTunes, I'll go on iTunes and watch stuff. Sometimes I'll watch like TV shows if I'm going somewhere on a long flight or something. And when I do, it's mostly like reality TV, like contests and stuff. Like I really enjoy that. I'm not into fictional TV that much. I love movies, but I can never get into like series like Game of Thrones or like something that's very drawn out, because I know deep down in my heart that I'm never going to commit the amount of time that it's going to take to watch through a whole series. So I don't even want to start it because I just don't want to spend the time on it. So yeah, I don't really watch a lot of TV or shows. I do like movies though. Like I said, I'm very much a very polarizing person when it comes to movies. I love horror movies. I love psychological thrillers. I really enjoy comedies. I kind of like Disney movies and like cartoony movies that are made for adults. I don't really like crime movies and drama movies and stuff like that. Like I want things to happen in the movies at all time, but I also don't want it to be action movies where there's just like a bunch of shooting and stuff. Like I don't care about that either. I don't know. I have a very particular taste when it comes to movies, I suppose. And since I don't really like TV, no real reason to talk about that. Honest, do you cut your own bangs? And if so, can we get a tutorial? Because they always look super cute. I do cut my own bangs. I mean, it's nothing crazy. I mean, if I had a pair of scissors here, I would show you. But I basically just like take my bangs like this. Usually I'll do like two parts, and I'll just kind of use my scissors and like trim them like that, and then do the same on the other side, and then sometimes I will kind of like snip a little bit in the middle. It's really nothing fancy. I just kind of take it slow, and then, you know, I'll stop cutting when I'm happy. But I've had bangs my whole life, so I'm very used to it, and it's something that is kind of just second nature to me now. And yeah, I mean, like I said, it's really nothing fancy. Do you base your outfit around your makeup, or your makeup around your outfit? If you've been on my channel for a while, you know how many times after filming a video I've been like, alright, I guess I have to go change now because my makeup does not match my outfit. So clearly it just depends. Usually I'm gonna have to change after doing my makeup, because if I'm doing my makeup, I'm usually like reviewing something or trying something new, and then it just depends on which colors in the palette that I want to test out for the day, or which palettes that I want to use for the day. That's kind of going to decide on the kind of makeup look that I want to do. And then, yeah, I mean, my clothing just has to change after. That's probably why I wear a lot of black, because it's just a lot easier that way and I don't have to worry about it so much. But yeah, usually my makeup will choose my outfit for the rest of the day. So someone here has a lot of questions about like my base makeup, since I always start off with my base mostly already done. That's one thing I want to get better at doing, like maybe next year, is doing a little bit more like full face of makeup kind of videos, because I feel like I never do that. But I just don't really try out that many new like base products, and it's not something that I really enjoy making videos on because I find it kind of boring and I never watch those videos myself. But I do try different foundations from time to time, but I want to say that I have like two or three that I usually rotate between, and I always usually switch up like my blushes and stuff. But as for like my concealer and foundation and powder, usually it stays the same within like 2 or 3 variations. So I just don't feel like full face of makeup videos for me would be that interesting because I just always do the same thing. I did make a video not that long ago showing like my base makeup routine. I will have that linked up in the corner. It was just like my foundation routine or whatever, like if you want to see it. But I just don't find it to be that interesting. Let me know if you want to see more videos like that for me, and I can probably do so. If you want to see me review some foundations, maybe I can do that. I don't know. I feel like those videos that I have done in the past just hasn't done very well for me, so probably another reason why I just don't really do them. But let me know if you do want to see that. I'm not going to be one of those like chatty get ready with me while we talk about XYZ kind of channel, because I just don't have like that many opinions about a lot of things enough that I want to make a full video about it. I'm not very good at talking about the same subject for a long period of time. Like I usually have very short snippets of opinions that I can give on a topic or whatever, but I can't fill it like with a whole video like some people do. Some people can talk about the same thing for 30 minutes and I don't understand how, and they still make it interesting. Like I'm not a good storyteller, so I'm not going to be like a storytelling type channel. But yeah, if you want to see more base makeup videos, do let me know down below. This is such a good question and I wish I had an answer for it, but I said, if it was possible to do a PSA for every new subscriber so you wouldn't have to repeat yourself, what would it be? If you got nothing nice to say, don't say it, you know? If you wouldn't say it to someone's face, don't tell it to someone on the internet. Like, that is just not cool. I guess it's not really a PSA, but it's just something that really bothers me, and I feel like there's just a lot of rude people on the internet. Now, I'm very lucky to not get a lot of those myself, but there's just some comments that make me scratch my head and be like, you would never tell your friend that, or you would never tell your mom that, or you would never tell like a person on the street that. Like, why are you telling me? Like, you don't even know me. Like, shut your fucking mouth. I'm sorry, but like, come on. If you could curate your own eyeshadow palette, what colors and formulas would you pick? I love your style and I'm interested in what direction your creativity would go. Okay, so I'm gonna do one more because my battery is dying and I've been filming for over 40 minutes now. So this one says, do you have a game plan for being an up-and-coming influencer, and do you think reaching more than 26k followers has changed your channel? I don't think that my channel has changed, but the way that I approach things and the way that I say things maybe have changed a little bit. I feel like I'm scared to have very strong opinions about anything that's not makeup, and I just don't want to stir the pot with anything. Like, I never talk about politics on my channel. I never talk about anything that are going to make people mad, because there's just absolutely no point in that. Like, that is not the kind of channel that I want to be. I want this to just be about makeup. I just want to inspire people to have fun with makeup. I'm never going to become a commentary channel or anything like that, and I just don't want to share my personal opinions about things outside of makeup with the internet. Like, it makes me extremely uncomfortable to even read the comments of other people's videos, so it's not something that I'm willing to really openly speak about on my channel anymore. And I feel like I did that a little bit more in the beginning of my channel just because I didn't really have a lot of people watching me and everybody was really nice. But moving forward, it's definitely not something that I will be speaking on a lot, and I'm just going to keep it about the makeup because that to me is what I want my channel to be about. I just want to encourage people to have fun with makeup and not be scared of makeup and just see makeup as a way to express yourself instead of trying to make yourself look like the best person you can be in your makeup, you know, because that is not how I view makeup, and I want other people to experience makeup the same way. So those are going to be all of the questions for today. I mean, I have a lot more. If you want to see another Q&A, do let me know, and I can probably do so, even though I somehow never seem to get around to filming these, but I finally had a lot of time today, so hope you're enjoying Annette-mas so far. If you want to see some of the other videos that I've done in December, you can click on one of these, and if you're new to my channel, I would love it if you would consider subscribing, and I will see you in my next one.